now that we've got all the details about our drivers, how do I actually plan the work that they're going to do?
Right, okay. When you bring the rotor into the system, we can initially, the first part of the process is to take the rotor and allocate drivers to the rotor, so that once that's in, until that rotor changes, that will keep rolling on. If the rotor rotates, drivers will just move down that rotor as far ahead as needs to happen. So they're all fixed. What the system then worries about or helps you with is any driver that's not doing what they're scheduled to do, and also where you have a, might have a situation where there isn't a driver at all on a rotor line. And there's two ways we look at that. First of all, we look at what's called the forward allocation section. And the idea of this is to allow you to plan a week of work at once rather than just trying to do it on a daily basis. And across the top, hopefully you've noticed, Aidan, that there's a little bit of color coding going on. That's just a very quick method of saying open duties versus spare staff. The system works on the principle that you will have spare staff built into your rotors. So it's saying for me, if I was allocating this week of work for the 17th of October onwards, I really need to focus heavily on Thursday and Saturday. But actually on Sunday, I've got an extra member of staff, so I can start to look how I allocate to take those numbers into account as I allocate. So the bottom section, the blocks, this is in the middle, these are duties that are open, and I'm just going to change this so I'll just show the full week. So these are weeks where there's either somebody on holiday for the week or any sort of other absence. And you can see what that is by looking at the person's details down the left. That's the work for the week in question, but it also tells you what the weeks prior to that, were scheduled to work, just so you've got a flavour of sort of a bigger picture of the process. In the bottom section, these are drivers who potentially are available to pick up a week of work. Throughout this process now, it will start to be checking legality. If I try to allocate something that wouldn't be legal, it will quite happily tell me that and stop that process. But I'm just going to pick some duties to allocate to this particular driver here. So it's a very straightforward, select the duties you want to give to that person. You can pick them basically from any rotor line to suit. And this is where then you'll be factoring in the information you've got about Thursday and Saturday potentially. And may want to, so on this occasion, I've now decided I will change this. I won't give them work on Sunday because I knew it was okay Sunday. I'm going to instead give this driver some work on the Saturday. So those five duties highlighted as allocating, this driver now has got a week of work. So that quite quickly can take care of a lot of the full weeks of work. But if now I can move on to the daily side of the allocation process, this now is where, if you have a supervisory team, this is where they'll spend most of their time. This is the daily allocation screen where, as things happen live, this is where drivers have to, the supervisors have to deal with it. So the way this depot is configured, we have two drivers that we call standbys. So this one reports at 6 o'clock and is available till 1 o'clock. This one reports at 11 o'clock and is available till 6:30 in the evening. So that's the information that we need at this stage. On the left would be any open duties, and we can have a look at tomorrow and I can show you the process of that. I've got this position where what I would call the ideal situation is you're walking in the supervisor early in the morning, you've got two spare drivers during the day, and you've at the moment no open duties. But so we'll look at what happens if a driver doesn't come to work, and I'll talk you through that process.
Let's do that, yeah.
Yeah, so let's say we'll pick a driver who has called in, not able to come to work due to sickness. Incidentally, as I go through, anywhere you see this symbol that we call the cog, I'm using a left click option on that, and that's specifically because this could be run on a touchscreen device, specifically a tablet, so it doesn't have to be somebody sitting in an office. This could be somebody who might be out in a yard somewhere or working slightly remotely from the main office, particularly in that morning run out period where things happen. It needs to be a lot more dynamic. So I'm going to deallocate the driver, and as we said, he's not coming in due to sickness. So we record that it's sickness. We record a reason why. So he said he's got flu, and we can make a comment. say something in relation to the call. So we'll say, and this information transfers through to the personnel system, and therefore if ever there's an interview, you can refer back to these comments and see what was actually said when the call was made. He's also indicated he's no intention of coming back this week. He plans to come back on the 17th. So what we've got now is an open shift on the left-hand side of the screen. So we need to deal with that. It's now 7:22. I need, no, I've got to deal with this problem now at 7:25. So first of all, I don't have a person. If I click on the duty itself, we get quite light green shading. That means that the people I've got could do that shift, but couldn't do all of that shift. And what it's also telling me is the green section here is that they know the route, and that would be the implication. If I say allocated this to duty to Mr. Selby, it tells me there will be an overtime implication of 5 hours, 27 minutes. So I'm not going to take that option. So instead I'm going to split the duty. Very straightforward. I'm going to split it in time to allow it for Mr. Selby to operate it. So I now need to refer to the bus stop list and find a suitable point where I can take that driver off. So we'll pick that one and we'll save that. So I now have a piece of work from 7:25 until 12:42 and a piece of work from 15:37 till 18:27. So as I highlight that now, it tells me that the perfect person to operate it is this one here, already working, already being paid. So, and I can drag that across and allocate it to him. So that one's done. I now just need to notify that driver that the piece of work's there. At this point, for tidiness, I will also make sure I cover this piece of work and it'll be allocated to across here to Mr. Evans. So with a very few quick clicks, and we've had a problem with the driver not coming, with sufficient time, it's been allocated to somebody and it's still within the time that it's due to leave the depot. Although it's not always that simple, unfortunately, and I'm sure you're aware of other things can happen during the day.
That's true. Yeah.
Yeah. So what we can also do at this stage is look at taking a part of a duty off. So this is somebody who, let's say, for some reason cannot finish their duty. So again, I bring up the driver in question, and we want to, I'll deallocate them this time because they've got an urgent domestic problem. So again, we select the right code, and every one of the codes on that list somewhere will potentially affect pay. So for example, urgent domestic is set up to deduct any hours that aren't worked. Others may be paid release for some reason, such as trade union release, that sort of thing. Again, we'll look at how the duty splits. And this person actually wants to be covered from that relief point until the end of their shift. So we've got an urgent domestic need. Again, we could put a comment in, whatever's caused that driver not to be available for work. So I'm going to have a very short piece of work. I know from my spares I don't have anybody to give it to, so I now have to look at excuse me, some other options of who may be available to operate that. So the system will tell me any driver that is available and can legally operate the duty. If it's red, then we won't even look at those. But what it's giving me is a list of people who potentially are available, and this is the crucial column, at the time they last signed off. So at what time they will be available from to be able to therefore operate that duty. And this is the last time they went on a bus. So it gives a flavour of how long they've been driving before you can put them on. So for argument's sake, if I wanted to give to this person, he's actually driven 3 hours virtually already. So you might not want to give him that because he doesn't have a lot of time off in between. And this one again, driven quite a while. So the one I'm going to pick is this one here and allocate it to him. So that driver has now got that work. What we can do, just to, we can, I can, if you can indulge me a little bit more, go a bit deeper into the system and show you other areas where where that can be reflected. So it's for today. Now, if I look at the details, this is the person just being given the overtime. And it's there now shown. So on his list for the day is that the extra work. Also in the show work screen, we have what we try to do is keep information to hand so that people can easily, the supervisor can very quickly get to information. So as soon as you go into show work, you get somebody's contact number and a contact email, such should you want to quickly contact them about, such as about the overtime. But we can also make some changes in here. So, and do you ever get drivers who want to say, instead of working at having a rest day off, they want to work it and having a different day off in the same week? Does that happen?
Oh, rest day swaps, yes, that happens. Yes. Yeah.
Okay, so that's, we've built this into this part of the system, so it's quite a quick process. So this driver in particular wants to work Monday and have Saturday off. So he's done that, and straight away, that's, in my eyes, that's identified a little trend there as well. We've got an annual holiday on a Saturday, now he wants a Saturday off, and that's, that information is there in the system, that you can very quickly see trends like that if they start to form, if you have a mind to look for them. So now, again, it's a code system, so XR and RS, the two codes involved with the rest day swap, will affect the driver's guaranteed pay for the week. It means if he doesn't hit the guaranteed pay week with the duties we allocate to him, then he won't get paid his guarantee. And this, throughout the system, these codes are making these subtle changes. So to complete the process, I can now go straight to the allocation screen for Monday the 18th and allocate this driver a duty now so that the process is complete. So at this point, the driver has no guarantee of any sort. He's sort of at your mercy, shall we say. So you can give any duty that you may struggle to cover. So I'm going to select on this occasion, I'm going to select quite a short duty because I know that the driver doesn't have a guarantee anymore. So allocate and that. And that process is now complete for the driver in question. So we've ended up, I've gone back to today's screen because if you remember when the driver didn't show in for work, he actually said he wasn't coming in for the rest of the week. So just kind of a quick look at the impact on how that affects tomorrow. So just quick, I can easily move across. And there he is, the one who rang in sick, Mr. Hammond, still with a duty left to cover. And we also have some other duties to cover due to people being on holiday. At this moment in time, we have 5 spare drivers. So if, for argument's sake, I want to allocate this one, if I just click on that, what that's done straight away is tell me that this particular driver, Mr. Anderton, doesn't have knowledge of the 42 route. So the 42 route is on the duty that I've highlighted. So Mr. Anderton doesn't have the knowledge of that. So probably won't allocate it to him. We'll give that to somebody else. So I'll just drag across and give it to that person. As we can see, there's more duties than drivers. So we can also call upon the resters section. So these are people who are scheduled to rest that day. And again, same process. We can drag across and allocate to that, to any member of staff. And it has, again, the pop-up there were around codes and how you pay that driver for a rest day. So that's just a brief look at the allocation on the things that are taken into account. Do you also, I meant to ask you, do you have drivers who swap duties between themselves?
Yes. So
what's called a mutual,
yes, we do.
Mutual swap. Yeah, we can handle those. Yep, quite quickly. So obviously you'd know the two drivers in question. I'm just going to pick two from the list. Lift the drivers. And that pops up their duty details that's in the system for the coming weeks and any, the week that's open that's live and any coming weeks. So for argument's sake, they've asked you if they can swap on Wednesday the 27th of October. So hit that confirm and submit, and that's now done. Throughout the system now, the clocking system, the allocation screen, that's done. And again, the code is showing up as MX because the driver's changed what they're supposed to do. Therefore, that will affect pay, particularly around the guaranteed week, etc.
All right, excellent. So thank you, Mark. That's covered a lot of detail about all the different ways of allocating work and all the different scenarios that can happen and how we deal with them. So when it comes round to the day of operation, I also want to allocate a bus. with the shifts. So can I do that?
Yep, we have a separate section for vehicles, and very much like we did with the drivers, actually, you have to set them up in the system, very much like the personnel system. So the vehicle is relatively surprisingly less complex. So you set up your vehicles initially, and you can set, excuse me, a number of attributes to those vehicles, and a number of different things. So branding, which is quite a strong thing these days, and a specific description, and a vehicle type. And the vehicle type can go right back through to your scheduling system. So you can set the vehicle types in there, and it flows all the way through, and you can mirror it then in this part of the system. Attributes, you may want to say that it's got a next stop display or something like that, or it has specific type of CCTV. Those all can sit within there. We then come to a parking plan. So we can have a parking plan that mirrors the layout of your yard or your depot, so that you can see as you park a vehicle, it's in the position it's in. And also then that is in the right order then to affect the run out when you do start to plan the run out for the day in question, which takes me on to this part. So at this point now, the list on the left, it's all based on what the system calls a run number, which is, I think, the terminology running board. It's what the vehicle does for the day. So you're now allocating a vehicle to a vehicle working.
Yeah.
So as I select a vehicle type, it tells me all the vehicles of that type that are available. It's very straightforward. And then you can allocate then across to that, and that's allocated. If we look at the vehicles that are allocated, you can see the drivers that are scheduled to drive that. That may be useful on the day to see if you know you've got a problem with a specific vehicle, who's going to be driving it next and what their duty details are, but also that can be historic. So you can go back and see who drove a bus on a particular day going back, because it stores that information.